to revise our topic. But in the meantime, this is now, my experience in multimedia, our topic is multimedia for global communication. To think of the globe, to think of the world sometimes can be too overwhelming, can be too big a task. But to communicate to someone and assure and be assured that you have connected with that someone is probably one of the most satisfying experiences of being able to relate to another. And I'd like to go further reaching out to the other person through you. And Multimedia comes in as another tool, comes in as another tool of reaching out, another faith reaching out. Like the sons, okay? The sons were written many, many years ago. But the psalmists decided to write it down eventually. And then an inventor, Gutenberg, invented the printing press. Because before it was distributed by hand, you had to copy the Bible before. Many people can be in. But there's an inventor who said, I will invent a moving type press. So that every time I do this, I can make 1,000 copies in 5 minutes or so. And then eventually, all of us now are dedicating to reading it. And that's a book, that's paper. Now, we have electronics, we have Multimedia. And think about that. What is the Lord saying to each one of you? Okay, what is the Lord saying to each one of you? And if he's even asking Father, what is the Lord asking you to tell somebody else? And then if you have skills in Multimedia, maybe you can use that tool to communicate that one. Okay? Okay, this one, I just showed it.
What struggles you are going to claim?
Okay, the next video I'd like to show you is something that I have done on a professional level, because I do Multimedia on many levels. I do it as a hobby, first and foremost. Because as a hobby is, I do it for love. I do it for love. When I do a video of my home, of my family, no one's paying me, but I'm doing it for love. I want to remember moments of my family. Okay? I want to remember it, so I made a Multimedia. But the next set of videos is something like that when I was in television. I worked with the Technology and Livelihood Resource Center. It had a co-production with GNA 7 before sometime in the 90s. It ran for maybe 7 years. Some of you were not born yet, but it's called Agri-Siete. Negosiete and Magnegosyo. These are business shows. Okay, these are business shows. Okay. And I've come to a realization in the course of my career that business is an important aspect of God's kingdom. It's an important aspect. There is always an economic side to the kingdom of God. And so I said, if the kingdom of God is composed of people who also run money, make money work. Then there is also a possibility that these business people can be holy, they can be saintly, they can be in accordance with the will of God. So I've heightened my interest in business. I've heightened my interest in integrating business, spirituality, communications, and things like that. So I decided, after a degree in communication arts, I thought I should go into Master's in Business Administration. So that's where I have been going to. And this set of videos are videos meant to communicate how to do business in the technology side of it. Like, for example, forestry. is at the border. Aquarium, who likes pet fish? Who has an aquarium here? Aquarium, anybody? We have an aquarium. Because we have studied how to take care of fish. Aquarium fish, for that matter. We studied how to do some landscaping. How to manage the water piece, you name it. When it comes to business technology, I probably have somehow studied about it, or at least ground school. But this set of videos are the ones that I have done in the series. You will see a mixture of photos and videos and text. And this has been done, by the way, in around the Philippines. And since our topic is supposed to be global, my belief is think global, but act local. Okay? You are a citizen of the world, not just of the Philippines. Okay? So anything you communicate to your shipmate is actually part and parcel of communicating to the whole world. That is in essence, that is it. If it is public, of course, but you can think of that. Okay, but think globally, in fact, think universally, but act globally. Like I met Stevenson earlier, realized that Stevenson's taking up law. Okay, so he's now an expert in law in Korea, or about to become one. But I'm encouraging you to study multimedia because he can be the expert in multimedia and law in Korea. Okay, so now this one is entrepreneurship, business technologies on video. You will see a very young people. Do you know Aiza Seguera? Okay, Aiza Seguera was our talent here. He was here very young. The late Bert Marcello, a comedian, he passed away already. And you also see Lou Veloso. Do you know Lou Veloso, a comedian? And Carmen Moreno.
Yes.
Carmen Moreno. Gina Alohar. Okay. Probably you recognize the faces, okay? But, you know, part of multimedia work is being able to work with the opinion makers. Work with opinion makers because they are the ones who most probably will be able to influence the ones you wish to reach. Okay, this is the, this is the from offering you some. Okay, I'm going to do the lip sync because now, but that's Isa Sigera, this one. It's moving also on the front. Must have been something wrong with the encoding of the audio. Now, this is one thing with multimedia. You have to really pay close attention to the technical side of it.
Things that I will not trade for.
Okay. Now this is the proposal that I wish to rephrase our topic for today. Still within the area of the topic, but I wish to rephrase our objectives today is to grow your business and career passionately. Create and engage in multimedia. Multimedia is there. The global is not exclusive, but when I say grow your business and your career, regional title was globally. Grow your business and career globally. But then, as I mentioned earlier, maybe think of the word at this time, maybe too overwhelming. So I suggested to rephrase it and to use another term, which is passion. Create your business and your career, to build, grow your business and your career passionately. Now, what is your business now? Is there somebody here who is already a son or a daughter or an entrepreneur? Anyone? May I see someone here? Is there anybody here who is already a son or a daughter of somebody whose business is like maybe marketing or food? What was the business of your parents? Retail shops. Okay, retail, for example. Okay. So have you participated in that business? No? Okay. Because you studied psychology. Okay. But you know, come to think of it, you already have your business now. And your business is to study. Okay. Your business is to study. Your career is to study. So do your best. English. Study English. Practice English. This one I will say yes, it's really for global. If there's one thing that I really am thankful for, it's that because I came from a school that taught me English well. I also came from a family who encouraged writing and speaking. And I spent their fortune in letting me study the books too. I probably would have studied here too, because I only live in Balikina also. But there was my school there in also. I was in Golden Parks. Actually, I was in Quezon City before, in Lourdes School. I studied my day school in Lourdes School, Quezon City. And I was fortunate that English was taught to me well, and I was also fortunate that I was receptive to the teaching, because maybe my teacher said, but I'm not interested. And I'm happy I was. So I'm encouraging all of you to be interested. Try not to pay the fines. No. Do your best to practice. That's the best way to do it. And also in writing, by the way. I noticed that most of the young people now have not practiced writing in English. Why? Because of text messaging. Text messaging has made English difficult to learn, because we understand the text, the short message. Okay? But that's my encouragement. So this is my proposal now. Your role is a student, so your business is a student, and do it passionately. Why am I emphasizing passion? Okay? Because most successful, if not all, the successful people are passionate. Okay? They are passionate with what they do. Not even by passion, by the way. Anyone? Not even by passion. Anyone? I'll give my laptop to one. Just kidding. Anyone? What is passion? Passion. Huh? Passion? Anyone? Okay. When you love something, you are passionate about something, you love doing it, you don't get tired, right? You don't get tired. You don't stop learning. You just keep what maybe psychology is a passion, people. The human psyche, has her passion. To study the human psyche is probably one of the most difficult passions to do, but it can be done. The human mind, to understand the human mind and heart and spirit for that matter, is something really worth studying passionately for a lifetime. And then I say NBG Multimedia. Why do I say NBG? Because that's what we have now. We have a product, we have a tool, we have a medium that can encourage engagement, that can encourage interaction, that can encourage two-way communication, or at least something like that. Okay, because there was a time when all we had to do was sit on our sofa and watch the television and not being able to talk at it, unless you go out and really call up, hey, you're telling the wrong news. Hey, Mr. Reporter, why are you calling? Why are you wishing Japan to be the target of the recent movie storm? But of course, it had to be the leader of the family to acknowledge, to rebuke our reporter. But then the talking back is needed, the ability to speak, to respond, to reply. That wasn't very possible before. But now we can. We can comment, we can like, we can share as instant as we wish. And that's what I wish by, that's what I mean by engaging.
Okay, that's me. I came from, I've been speaking about this for quite a long time. I
do it also. I don't just speak about it, I do it. And one of my favorite topics are about education.
So this one is about Bahrain Model United Nations Conference. And these are some certificates, okay? Study.
This one is a certificate that I use. Study. Yeah. Because I don't stop studying. I study two ways. One, formally. I go out, evening, I pay my tuition to study. In fact, and I buy a book, that's how I see it. I buy a book because I feel that this is like a tuition fee so that I will learn it from the author. But then the other way is also just doing it. Just do it. You have a phone, you have a camera, you have a computer. This is to it. Windows has its movie maker. Macintosh has its iMovie. We all of these things in the operating system. What you have to do is just try it. You know what? I realized that most people have not even touched movie maker. Windows movie maker. Ignore. Have you? At least try it, tinker with it.
Okay, what is multimedia? Okay, we now go down to the definitions according to this professor. Okay, it is the convergence of computers with video, film, sound, graphics, and text.
Can you see that? Video. Motion picture. Sound. I will do a sound. Tell me what sound it is. Is that okay? Is that okay? I will do a sound. Tell me if you can recognize it. Then I will. Okay, this is the sound. Somebody knows Tarzan here. Okay, so Tarzan, pricing novels before. Okay? Another pricing novels, maybe in the 1800s. Okay? Eventually become popular when an Olympic swimmer became Tarzan. The Olympic swimmer is named Jeremy Weissmuller. He's an Olympic swimmer. A movie was made out of that. The Tarzan, I know, then the Tarzan, Ron Ellie, Tarzan for television. Okay. And of course, there's the most recent Greystoke. Have you seen that movie? Greystoke, The Legend of Tarzan. Okay, that's Tarzan. Okay. But you see, the sound, I did not mention the name sound, but that sound is really part of our culture. It's part of our... Okay. Let me make another sound. Let me see if you know the sound.
Affecting you. Okay, this is the difference with mass media. Okay? It is a technological loom that weaves media together.
What is a loom? What is a loom? Okay. Can you see our textile being made? Okay. These are actually made of threads. And a loom helps it become textile, as we see now, and the tailor can make it into an attire, clothes. And this is what we do. Imagine video, photo, illustrations, words. Put them together in a nice combination. And put interaction via multimedia. And that's one thing, no? Computers.
I thank God for computers because we are now able to do this. Okay, they'll give promises to give people all kinds of classes of the power to seek, learn, create, and present information.
Okay, question for everyone. Are you hungry with knowledge? Because if you're hungry with knowledge, then you will continue to seek. You continue to search. And as long as you do it, might as well maximize multimedia for that.
Okay. Must contain interactivity, whereby a user becomes a participant in the communications, even a director or creator.
Must. Except with the mask. Okay? But of course, this is sometimes very difficult to achieve, but it must try to engage.
It must have an entertainment quality or intellectual level that compels a user into an interactive environment.
Entertaining, intelligent. Can you combine? Yes, it can be done, right? It can be both entertaining and intelligent. It can be done.
Okay. Okay, this one are some of the things I did.
Because this one, I just feel fancy. Okay. This one, the producers of Only Fancy to Agency wanted to come up with low budget videos that can be aired over television for 1 minute. Spots. Okay. And they found a team from Union College and also from the Communication Arts Department was also looking for things to do. And they got us. Now, the idea of this is to be entertaining, to be intelligent somehow, and also to sell, and to sell noodles, pancit. And the idea was pancit situations, to create situations of celebration where you will eat pancit. So they call it pancit situation. So we came up with scripts, and we did the production for around 2 days.
Thank you. somewhere that there should be some air flowing around so that the links would get on post properly, and therefore make it a more useful fertilizer sometime in the future. But I'm not sure if I'm doing it right. Sometimes I get problems with my family members thinking that this is some kind of dirt being accumulated in our backyard. And so I need confirmation whether I'm doing it right or I can continue this or not. Thank you. All your suggestions, your comments, and most welcome.
So I posted this one, and I did get some scientific comments which I have tried to apply.
Hello?
Okay, so let me ask you now, how much experience do you have in multimedia? Because I need to know also, who am I talking to in terms of experience? Okay? On a scale of 1 to 10, with 1 being little and 10 being considerable, what is your training in multimedia? Has anybody here ever attended a formal training in multimedia? Anyone? No one? I don't see any hands. What is your practice and experience in multimedia? Maybe you have done a video on your own, have you? Maybe you have taken photos and uploaded photos. That's part of multimedia in a way. Now on a scale of 1 to 10, with 1 representing ineffective and 10 representing highly effective, how would you rate your effectiveness as a multimedia publisher? Okay? Because bottom line, we all have to deal with effectiveness. Communicated well. Eventually, we have to ask ourselves, eventually, we have to ask whether the time and the effort we spent on doing a multimedia project was useful or not. And our goal is for effectivity. Let me see this one. Okay.
Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the starship University of Santo Tomas. Its lifelong mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before.
And then meeting the personal needs. minds of others. These are the two things that I, in terms of personal reasons. Let me show you this one later. Okay. So, on the top ones are the ones that are for growth.
It's not very clear. But you know, Multimedia is also an art form. Isn't it that when you draw something or you paint something, you're very happy, you look down, very beautiful picture? Isn't that so? Right? Same experience with doing Multimedia. Just new tools. But the feeling of being complete, the feeling of having achieved more. That's one of the things. And then, of course, Multimedia also helps others. Have you ever had the experience that your drawing or your painting, when seen by someone else, felt happier, maybe for the moment, felt so glad to see your picture? Same thing here. And I think the movies is a very good medium, because the movies can really uplift the spirit.
Now this one is the bigger picture. Okay. Let me show you my last video. Okay, this last video
is an interview. Okay, it's an interview. This is what I've been doing most of the time now. I interview people on record. And find out what they have to say, what they have to share. And this one, I realized that I talked to somebody, she's a coach, she's a personal coach, and this is how I've titled it, What's Stopping You?
And maybe to conclude our talk, I think about what's stopping you in doing Multimedia and forget about it. Forget what's stopping you. Just do it. Okay, finally. Okay, because finally I was asked earlier by Reverend Sung about the content. Because finally, what should we write about? What should we produce about? And I think one of the most universal things we can do is to post something about family. We speak of the family. Okay? So this is my own. I posted this on Facebook, which I've gotten several likes. This is another earlier photo. This is my mother. This is our mom. These are my daughters when they were younger. Same here. Okay. This one is a video, but I'm not sure this one. This one has other videos that I made about my family. Travel, you can write about travel. Okay. This one is a photo which I've taken in Bahrain, which I was a resident of Bahrain for several years. And this one is the burial mounds. It's an ancient site. And it was published in one of the books in Bahrain. Okay, so travel, this one is a video made by my daughter. Okay, this one. This one is one of my latest experiences, which I am so happy to be already sharing with people. But this is also about music, okay? Music has been found to be one of the things that people like to discuss and listen to. So this one, I think you'll be listening to three clips of music with a video that I am so happy about. It's a good like this one. team. Okay? We need some skills, a good skill in information technology. Okay. Tools for content creation. Okay. These are some software that you can use. Adobe and Apple with their products. And Microsoft Office also has very useful tools. These are some audio. These are just audio that I have. Okay. And there are some publishing platforms, YouTube and Vimeo. You can have an account there. For blogging, WordPress and bloggers, Facebook, LinkedIn, Bandpage, Instagram, Instagram, Twitter, Elisar, and some of the things you can. Okay, now this one is the last video. These are deaf, and I mixed it to a song. So, you know what? Every time I make Multimedia,
Mansion houses, smart TV. We have been promised each building a 230 feet boundaries. What class? Each lab. Mia, EJ, and who are the representatives? Jessica and Ian.
Okay, almost finished, so students can practice or they are